The USA is a big place with a rich history and a fascinating future. But what if we told you that this country might be harboring some mysterious things that you didn't know? But don't worry, it may be strange.
The organ was created by Leland W. Sprinkle. Mr. Sprinkle toured the caverns.
And it may be a little scary to explore the unknown, but it's never boring. So you came to the right place if you're ready to expand your mind and have a good time doing it. Here are 15 shocking things found in the United States, part 2. Number 15. Vashon Island Bike Tree. The kid's bicycle embedded into a tree is a bit of a tourist attraction here on Vashon Island, Washington, just outside of Seattle. It's also become a source of folklore and fake internet stories. That's why it's so popular. The most famous tale is that a young boy went off to fight in the World War and left his bike up against the tree and never came back, so the tree grew around the bike. Unfortunately, although it's a great story, it's fake. It's actually from the 1950s. The tree is believed to have grown around it. Two generations concur that the bicycle belonged to Don Poos, who in 1954 left his bicycle in the woods, forgot about it, and never went back looking for it. The bicycle wasn't his favorite. It had hard, solid rubber tires and skinny little handlebars like a tricycle. He and his friends were playing in the woods together. When the boys left, Don left his bike behind. After the bike was discovered, making headlines, both mother and son paid it a visit. And given the location of the bike within the tree and the manner in which these trees actually grow, it's quite unlikely the bicycle ended up in its current position through the tree's naturally enveloping, as many viewers assume. Almost certainly, one or more persons had a hand in moving the bike after Don abandoned it in 1954. Now, let's get ready for today's open discussion. We don't know what this or where this is, but we do know one thing: get us out of here. The incredible thing about America is that for everything fantastic about this great country, there's something else that just isn't. Could be downright mysterious, and in this case, a little terrifying. So what do you think this is? Is it a demon long buried in a tomb, finally freed from its dark abyss? Is this something from the gates of hell coming to wreak havoc? Probably not, but they could have fooled us. Let us know what you think it is in the comments using the hashtag #OpenDiscussion. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14. Centralia. This place once boasted 14 active coal mines and 2,500 residents in the early 20th century. Welcome to Centralia in Pennsylvania. But by the 1960s, its boomtown heyday had passed and most of its mines were abandoned. Still, over 1,000 people called it home, until a coal mine fire began below the town. In 1962, a fire started in a landfill and spread to the labyrinth coal tunnels that miners dug thousands of feet below the surface. Though competing theories exist about how the fire was sparked, it's thought that the Centralia dump fire sparked a much larger mine right beneath the town. And despite repeated attempts to extinguish the flames, the fire caught a coal seam and still burns to this day. When the coal mine fire began, residents thought it would quickly burn out on its own. But the fire is still burning nearly 60 years later. The fire that burns beneath the surface continues to spew poisonous smoke into the air through hundreds of fissures, and the ground is in constant danger of collapsing. The reason, ironically, is the aftermath of the mining that defined Centralia for all those years. There are so many abandoned mine tunnels in the area that one, many, or all could be fueling this fire. Number 13. President's Heads. Inspired by Mount Rushmore, President Park was built for $10 million in 2004, so visitors could walk among 20-foot-tall busts of the president while learning more about them. The busts themselves were created by a modernist sculptor. The busts were supposed to be destroyed, but Howard Hankins, a man whose construction company worked on the park, suggested moving them to his farm in Croker, Virginia instead. So began the laborious process of moving 43 giant presidents, each weighing in between 11,000 and 20,000 pounds, to a field 10 miles away. Apparently, the week-long process cost about $50,000, not including the damage done to each sculpture during the move. Holes had to be smashed into the top of each head to attach them to the cranes that lifted them onto flatbed trucks, and several were badly damaged in the process. Nevertheless, they made the move to Hankins Field, where they now reside. But Hankins' hope is to include them in an even more grand reimagining of President's Park, including an Air Force One fuselage, Secret Service Museum, First Lady memorabilia, Wounded Warriors Room, interactivity, and more. However, doomed by a poor location and lack of visitors, the park went under in 2010. Number 12. Flavor Graveyard. People take their frozen treats very seriously, and Ben & Jerry's knows this. The US-based ice cream company is known for creating weird and wonderful flavors with wacky names, including a crisp flavor called Chip Happens. So what does the company do to commemorate when a beloved flavor gets discontinued? Ben & Jerry's marks the ending of its flavor in the strangest way by burying them in a garden outside its factory. A tongue-in-cheek video by the brand shows people gathering together in a funeral-style setting, with people mourning the flavors and laying flowers at the headstones. And we get it. Nobody likes to see their favorite treats end up in a snack heaven. There's also a virtual version on Ben & Jerry's website. A statement from Ben & Jerry's on the page reads, "Ice cream flavors, like everything else, have a beginning and an end." The statement continues, "While some of our flavors have proven to live long and happy lives, others were cut down before their time, or in some cases, just in time. Here we pay tribute to our dearly depinted." Flavor experimentation comes hand in hand with risk, meaning that not so popular products can ultimately meet their untimely end. Number 11. Time Travel Mart. When you walk into this store, you might be greeted by the person behind the counter saying, "Hello again, I saw your future self in the store today. He told me you'd be coming in." And that's just the greeting. That future fun is what makes the Time Travel Mart such a success. The story goes like this. The man who started the first reading center in San Francisco was told by the city that he needs a storefront, so he set out to create the silly pirate shop that's become the flagship for the stores so that he can continue his nonprofit. Now the store itself is a tutoring center for students and budding literary enthusiasts age 6 to 18. It specializes in after-school tutoring, workshops, and programs. Though the shop primarily features quirky time travel items such as time-freezy hyper slush ice drinks and woolly mammoth chunks, visitors can also browse and purchase the students' publications, which are appropriately displayed in a freezer. Clever idea, right? The store is located in the historic Echo Park neighborhood of Los Angeles, California, and like all other 826 shops, functions as both a retail space and literacy tutoring center. The playful store theme serves to inspire creativity in its students, as well as bring a unique way of giving back. Number 10. Stalactite Organ. The Great Stalactite Organ in Luray Caverns was invented in 1954 by Mr. Leland W. Sprinkle of Springfield, Virginia, who worked at the Pentagon as a mathematician and electronic scientist. And it's a music marvel. You just tap the ancient stone formations with a small mallet, producing a musical tone. He was so greatly inspired by this demonstration, and the idea for a most unique instrument was conceived. He began his monumental 3-year project by searching the vast chambers of the caverns with the aid of 13 tuning forks, tapping potential formations, a painstaking process. Electronic mallets were wired throughout the caverns and connected to a large 4-manual console. When a key is pressed, a tone occurs as the rubber-tipped plunger strikes the stalactite tuned to concert pitch. Stalactites were selected from over 3.5 acres of the caverns and painstakingly altered to precisely match the tone needed to become part of what would eventually become the world's largest musical instrument. Today, the organ is played by activating an automated system that works in a manner like a child's music box. The organ is also fully capable of being played manually, as Leland Sprinkle did for many years. Number 9. Subtropolis. This Opus business station was created through the mining of a 270-million-year-old limestone deposit. And would you believe that 1,600 people work here? It's completely dry, brightly lit, with miles of wide paved streets accessed at street level. The pillars' even spacing, concrete flooring, and 16-foot-high smooth ceilings make build-to-suit facilities time and cost-efficient for tenants. A tenant requiring 10,000 to 1 million square feet can be in their space within 120 days. In the mining process, limestone is removed by the room and pillar method. leaving 25-foot square pillars that are on 65-foot centers and 40 feet apart. What's the big idea here? There are advantages to keeping things underground. The temperatures remain near constant, energy costs are lowered, and in the massive 55 million square foot space, there's a whole city of workers there to help. They say it's truly a green environment, with some suggesting businesses here are probably using about 75% less electricity underground than you would in an above-ground facility. Mining began in the 1940s, and the empty space grew under the limestone bluffs on the Missouri River. And now, they dubbed their underground city Subtropolis and called it the world's largest underground business complex. Number 8. Peephole Cinema. In a time when movie lovers can get their fix anywhere, from iPhones, streaming platforms to state-of-the-art theaters, this place has found a different way to screen films. Peephole Cinema in San Francisco displays silent films, each a few minutes in length, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, through tiny peepholes in public spaces. Peephole Cinema started as a way to share films, animated and otherwise, with a broader audience than the animators at animation shows. However, the technical logistics of getting the films to run 24/7 was difficult at first. Also, very few people know about it. The location is not compatible with a quick Google search for art. People could miss it because it's such a low-profile place, but that's also what makes it so special. Who doesn't like a treasure hunt of art? Potential viewers need to hear of the project's existence from a friend or stumble on it in their wanderings. The alley housing Peephole Cinema, while not famous itself, is filled with murals. Murals may be one of the biggest attractions in this district today, but tiny film scenes also have historic roots in San Francisco. One of the first kinetoscopes, a device in which viewers gazed at films through a peephole, was installed on Market Street in the 1890s. Number 7. Thor's Well. Check out this gaping hole on the edge of the Pacific Ocean, which appears to swallow the ocean and powerfully shoot it back out over the surrounding rocks. Known as the Drain Pipe of the Pacific, Thor's Well is one of the most unique sites on the Oregon coast, and we can see why. It was formed when the thrashing ocean eroded a sea cave, causing it to collapse and leaving a natural hole, around 20 feet deep, in the rock. And for obvious reasons, it draws tourists, photographers, and nature lovers to gaze upon the powerful display of nature. It's especially popular at high tide when Thor's Well is in full force. High tide and stormy weather showcase Thor's Well at its finest and are the most popular times to visit. For those who want to get up close, it's best to visit close to high tide on a relatively calm day. When the tide is high or the weather stormy, the waves of oncoming tides surge water under the bowl-shaped hole, filling it from underneath. After a few seconds, the bowl overflows and sprays water over the surrounding rocks, creating a very unique sight. It's almost like Thor's Well is draining the ocean and shooting it back out. Thor's Well tip: make sure to check the tide times before you visit. Number 6. Camera Obscura. It's based on a 15th century design by Leonardo da Vinci, which uses a pinhole opening to let in sunlight and project an image of the surrounding area. And it's been here since the 1860s, and this one in Land's End has been in practice next to the Cliff House restaurant for 7 decades. You can step inside and observe this old technology working around you, and a giant precursor to the modern camera. Da Vinci really was a genius. The camera's lens rotates 360 degrees and projects the captured image onto a projection table within the camera. There's also a 150-inch lens and mirror, which are used to magnify and rotate the image so that it's viewable by those inside the camera. Visitors can walk around the projection table and observe the camera in action as it captures live images from the surrounding Pacific Ocean, Ocean Beach, Seal Rocks, and more. You can also see a holograph collection that was added in 1979. The building, which houses the camera, is about 17.5 feet by 17.5 feet, and the exterior was remodeled several times. The current exterior is more or less how it looked since 1957, and the projection table and lens are both original. So a visit into this is truly like stepping into the past. Number 5. Dinosaur Tracks. Hikers, historians, and writers who are obsessed with dinosaurs should visit here. It features the largest dinosaur tracks in North America, plus prehistoric rock art and ancient ruins. Hidden, yet easily accessed in southeast Colorado, Picket Wire is located within the Comanche National Grassland. There are many side attractions, Besides dinosaur tracks, there are incredible Spanish expeditions, ancient ruins, restaurants that make this site worth visiting, and you can join hundreds of visitors to check out the footprints of dinosaurs in the mud, which are over 150 million years old. Explore more than 13,000 tracks left by early dinosaurs and 100 different trackways. The footprints left on the mud are that of the Allosaurus and Brontosaurus, and they are the reason the Picket Wire Canyonlands is a national treasure as far as dinosaur prints are concerned. Scientists have been able to get more information about dinosaurs' social behavior through this track site. A significant portion, about 40% of the total tracks left in the region, are from the Brontosaurus, known as the plant-eating dinosaurs. No wonder they loved it here. If you had the opportunity to visit, you'd understand why hundreds of families came here to spend their holiday each year. Time spent in this historic place is always a charm. Number 4. Smiley Face Forest. The general consensus is that Disneyland is the happiest place on Earth, but residents of Oregon know that the happiest place on Earth is, in fact, a green hillside visible from Route 18. Located near Wilhelmina, Oregon, there's a big yellow smiley face made entirely out of fir trees that's visible every year. In 2011, two Hampton Lumber employees decided to create an arboreal design that would evoke joy in every person who saw it. So they designed a smiley face similar to an emoji that would greet motorists as they drove through the area. They created the smiley face by planting a mixture of larch, which is a type of fir tree that turns yellow in the fall, and evergreen Douglas fir trees. Larch trees form the circular face, and Douglas fir trees form the wide, happy eyes and smiling mouth. Planting fir trees in a circular design was no easy feat. After a decade in existence, the larch and Douglas fir tree smiley face is just now starting to slightly fade. Still, countless weary motorists traveling Route 18 have spontaneously smiled as soon as they spotted a big, bright smiley face made up out of fir trees on the horizon. Sadly, in a few decades, all of the trees that form the smiley face will be harvested and converted into lumber, which will be used to build houses and other building projects. Number 3. Rock Art Ranch. This place has immense archaeological significance. Researchers from the Smithsonian Institution, Heard Museum, and other museums and universities visit here regularly. Encompassing 5,000 acres between Winslow and Holbrook, Rock Art Ranch is a cattle ranch and home to one of the best preserved and most extensive collections of ancient petroglyphs in the world. Images etched into rocks adorn cliff faces, alcoves, and overhangs in scenic Chevelon Canyon. It's a narrow, steep-walled gorge carved by a perennial creek. The only access to the canyon for several miles occurs at the ranch, where a break in the wall creates a sort of natural stairway. At these steps, supplemented by a few man-made ones and handrails, guests climb down into the heart of the rock art displays. Petroglyphs can be seen throughout a 2-mile stretch of canyon, with the highest concentration covering a quarter-mile section flanking the entry point. You'll spot the first markings as you descend the step. Upon reaching the creek, continue straight ahead to see one of the most dramatic images, believed to be a fertility symbol. The ranch features a museum stocked with artifacts found on the property, which has deep Arizona roots. Number 2. Mystery Soda Machine. On the corner of John Street and 10th Avenue East, in the heart of Seattle's charismatic Capitol Hill, lies a mystery. Not unusual for Seattle, however, the world's most mysterious soda vending machine stood for years. But who first installed the outdoor machine? Who stocks it? And who collects the money? Those are all things that make up the mystery. And now it's gone missing. So where did it go? A message was posted to the machine's social media page stating, "Going for a walk, need to find myself, maybe take a shower even." A note was taped to the rail where the machine used to be. And of course, the internet went crazy with photoshopped images of the soda machine traveling the world. Its dusty exterior and vintage beverages bring memories of days gone by. And the choices. A drink could be chosen using one of the mystery buttons, and the dispensed drinks were vintage flavors not ordinarily available in the US, or cans that have not been around since the 1980s. Total nostalgia. You got your Mountain Dew Whiteout, or a Raspberry Nesty Brisk, or the classic Hawaiian Punch. Don't leave out Grape Fanta. These were all iconic beverages for soda lovers back in the day. Number 1. Georgia Guidestones. These nearly 20-foot granite slabs have sparked controversy around the world. Decades after being erected, the monument's true purpose is still being argued, and its quasi-commandments can seem either sincere or sinister. We're intrigued. The monument 5 upright stones topped by a capstone weighs nearly 240,000 pounds and is inscribed in 8 languages with 10 instructions for humans post-apocalypse. The stones also boast a few odd astronomical features: a hole through which you can see the North Star each night, a slot through which you can watch the sunrise during the summer or winter solstice, and a hole on the capstone which functions as a solar calendar at noon. Conspiracy theorists claim to have decoded them. Pagans have held rituals around them. Graffiti artists have defaced them. They're as riveting for their curious origins and enigmatic intentions as they are for the cacophonous range of responses they evoke in observers. The monument was commissioned in 1979 by a now deceased anonymous donor calling himself R.C. Christian. A year later, on March 22, 1980, the Guidestones were unveiled on a former cow pasture in the U.S. Highway 77. We can't say we're really all that shocked to find more amazing stuff inside the great United States. It's the land of the free and the home of the brave, after all, and for good reason. Since you're here, like and subscribe and share these videos with all your friends.